Hello students, welcome to tutoringcluster.com. Now in this video we are going to talk about heat pump. What are the applications of heat pump, how we can calculate the coefficient of performance of heat pump, and we are going to solve a very good examples on heat pump. So if you are new to my YouTube channel, please do like and subscribe. You can also join us on the Telegram channel where I have already uploaded all the 4 unit notes for free. So let us start with the lecture. Now, what are the heat pumps? Now, basically, heat pumps are the devices which delivers heat energy at higher temperature at the expense of external work. Okay, let us try to understand what are the heat pumps. Okay, now let's say a winter season is going on and there is a very cold weather outside. So this is your surrounding. Okay, so a very cold weather is there, winter is going on. Okay, and let's say this is your room. Okay, now what I want, that as the temperature is very less, so I want some warmness in my room. I want to heat, or I want to increase the temperature of the room, right? So if you want to increase the temperature of this room, you will have to add the heat energy into it. You will have to add the heat energy into it. So you can take the heat energy from the surrounding and you can pass that energy into the room so that the temperature of the room, it will increase. Now the function, this function will be performed by heat pump. So basically it delivers the heat energy, let's say into the room. Now to perform this work, you will have to give some work input. You will have to give some work input to the heat pump. Okay, see how this work. So you are having an heat pump. This is your heat pump. So heat pump is going to supply the energy, heat energy, to the room. Let's say this is your room, which is at a temperature T1. It is going to supply the heat energy to the room so that the temperature of the room will increase and you will not feel cold there. Right. Now, from where it is going to get this heat energy? So it is absorbing this heat energy from the surrounding. So this is your surrounding. This is, let's say, at a temperature T2. Okay, again, T1 is more than T2. Okay, that means again heat is flowing from lower temperature to the higher temperature. Again, this is low temperature and this is high temperature. Okay, so to perform this transfer of heat from low temperature to higher temperature, you will need to give some input to the heat pump. So what is the function of heat pump? Heat pump, it delivers the heat energy at a higher temperature at the expense of external one. Okay, so if you remember my previous video in which I have explained you about a refrigerator, we have drawn the same sketch for refrigerator, but the function of refrigerator and heat pump the applications are different. They are opposite. Refrigerator, if you are writing here R, Q2 is more important. Why? How much amount of heat you are removing from the compartment. But if you are considering this as heat pump, how much energy you are rejecting into the room, or how much energy you are supplying, how much heat energy you are supplying into the room is more important. आप अगर ज्यादा हीट एनर्जी यहाँ पे सप्लाई कर सकते हो सो टेम्परेचर ऑब्वियसली इजीली बढ़ जाएगा. ओके, Q2 इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट इन केस ऑफ हीट पंप. व्हाट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट? Q1, हाउ मच एनर्जी यू आर पुटिंग इन टू द रूम. आप कितनी एनर्जी सराउंडिंग से एब्सॉर्ब कर रहे हो एंड यू आर पुटिंग इनसाइड द रूम, इट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो Q1 इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट एज कंपेयर टू Q2. ओके, सो आई होप आपको रेफ्रिजरेटर और हीट पंप इसका डिफरेंस होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. ओके, अगेन आई एम टेलिंग इन केस ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेटर Q2 इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. हाउ मच हीट एनर्जी यू आर रिमूव फ्रॉम द कंपार्टमेंट रेफ्रिजरेटिंग स्पेस. ओके, बट इन केस ऑफ हीट पंप हाउ मच अमाउंट यू आर रिजेक्टिंग इन साइड द रूम इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. So if you want to write the COP of an heat pump, COP of an heat pump, definition to same rahega, desired output divided by work input. Now tell me what is more important in case of heat pump. Q1 is important and work input is W. So this is how COP of an heat pump can be calculated. Okay, now if you want to find a relationship between a COP of an heat pump and COP of a refrigerator, okay, see how you can find. So this is the COP of a heat pump. Now if I want to write the COP of a refrigerator, it will be Q2 divided by W. Okay, so this will be Q2 divided by Q1 minus Q2. And here also you can write Q1 divided by Q1 minus Q2. So now, therefore, COP of a heat pump minus COP of a refrigerator is equal to Q1 upon Q1 minus Q2 minus Q2 upon Q1 minus Q2. So denominator is same. So it will be Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1 minus Q2. So this will be equal to 1. Therefore, you have to remember COP of a heat pump minus COP of a refrigerator is always equal to 1. Remember this. Definitely, you will have MCQ on this. Relationship between COP of heat pump and refrigerator. Very important. Okay. Please remember this. Right, so I hope heat pump is clear to you. So basically, what is the function of heat pump? If you want to heat your room, so you will need heat energy. If you are putting your heat energy into the room, your temperature of room, it will get increased. So that's why heat pump, it has major application in which season? In case of winter, right? You will find this heat pump installed in foreign countries. ओके, इंडिया में तो इतना नहीं लगता है. ओके, मे बी इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, और इन उत्तराखंड वेयर द टेम्परेचर इज वेरी लेस इन विंटर, मे बी इन सम रूम्स और इन होटल्स हीट पंप्स विल बी देयर. बट इन फॉरेन कंट्रीज वेयर टेम्परेचर गोज बिलो 0 degree Celsius, डेफिनेटली हीट पंप्स आर नेसेसरी देयर to maintain the room temperature. So basically we are adding the heat energy into the room so that temperature of room it will get increased. So let us try to solve some examples on heat pump. Okay, so a heat pump is used to maintain a house at 25 degree Celsius. Okay, the house is losing the heat at the rate of 60,000 kilojoule per hour to the surrounding. Okay, while the heat generated in the house by the various appliances is 4000 kilojoule per hour. So if the COP of heat pump is 1.5, find the power required to drive the pump. Okay, first let us understand the example. Heat pump. So draw कर लीजिए heat pump पहले. Okay, it is going to take input Q1, this will be Q2, T2, and this is T1. Okay. Now, let us try to understand the example. What are the things given to you? Okay. Heat pump is used to maintain the house at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, this is your house. I have told you room. This you have to maintain at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, the house is losing the heat at the rate of 60,000 kilojoule per hour. So this is your room house. So it is rejecting the heat at 60,000 kilojoule per hour. Okay, and the heat generated inside the house or in the house by various application, it is 4,000. So this is 4,000 kilojoule per hour. Okay, abhi ek baat samajhiye. This is your room. Okay, various applications hote hain room mein, TV hai, freeze hai, all electrical appliances. Okay, electric iron hai. So there will be heat generation due to usage of various applications. वो कितना heat generate कर रहे हैं? 4000 kilojoule per hour. लेकिन क्या दिया हुआ है? It is given that the room or house is losing the heat at the rate of 60,000 kilojoule per hour. Generate तो 4000 ही हो रहा है, लेकिन reject कितना कर रहा है? 60,000. यानी Q1 कितना आएगा? That means room में 60,000 माइनस 4,000 कितना आएगा? 56,000 किलोजूल पर आवर. अगर इतनी हीट अपन डाल रहे हैं, इफ यू आर पुटिंग 56,000 किलोजूल पर आवर इनटू द रूम प्लस हाउ मच हीट एनर्जी इट इज गेटिंग जनरेटेड 4,000, 56,000 प्लस 4,000 कितना आएगा? 60,000. तो ये हाउस 60,000 हीट रिजेक्ट कर सकता है. ओके, सिर्फ 4,000 ही जनरेट हो रहा है, तो बाकी का कहां से आ रहा है? सो बाकी का हीट कौन सप्लाई कर रहा है? इट इज सप्लाइड बाय हीट पंप. ओके, दिस यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. इज इट क्लियर? सो हाउ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग Q1 बेसिकली? सो Q1 वी आर बेसिकली कैलकुलेटिंग बाय हीट लॉस फ्रॉम द हीट लॉस्ट from house minus heat generated in the house. Okay, so this is equal to 60,000 minus 4,000. So Q1 will be equal to 56,000 unit kilojoule per hour. Okay, you can convert this in किलोजूल पर सेकंड. कैसे करेंगे? 56,000 वन आवर मीन्स 3600 सेकंड. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी किलोजूल पर सेकंड व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 15.55 किलोजूल पर सेकंड इज नथिंग बट किलोवाट. इज इट क्लियर? ओके, नाउ सीओपी इज गिवन, दैट इज 1.5. सीओपी हाउ मच इट इज? 1.5. What you have to find out? You have to find out power required to drive the pump. That means you have to find out W. W will be equal to what? What is COP? Q1 upon W. So W will be equal to Q1 upon 1.5. What is Q1? Yes, what is Q1? Q1 it is given as 15.55 divided by 1.5. So how much it is? 15.55 divided by 1.5. 10.36 unit kilowatt. क्यू किलोवाट लिख रहा हूँ, देखो 15.5 का यूनिट क्या है, किलोवाट है, सो डब्ल्यू इज 10.36 किलोवाट. सो व्हाट विल बी आंसर, पावर रिक्वायर्ड टू ड्राइव द हीट पंप, हाउ मच इट इज, 10 किलोवाट, दिस इज योर आंसर. ओके, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल, ओके, टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ हीट पंप. ओके, वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल बेसिकली. नाउ लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट. नाउ ओके, द हीट पंप इज यूज टू मेंटेन द हाउस एट 24 डिग्री सेल्सियस. द हाउस इज लूजिंग द हीट एट द रेट ऑफ 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट टू द सराउंडिंग. ओके, द हीट पंप इज ड्रिवन बाय इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर, पावर रेटिंग इज 12 किलोवाट. ओके, अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एब्सॉर्ब फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग एंड सीओपी ऑफ एन हीट पंप. ओके, हीट पंप दिया है, लेट अस ड्रॉ द हीट पंप फर्स्ट, स्केच ऑफ हीट पंप. हियर 50% प्रॉब्लम विल बी सॉल्व विद दिस स्केच, सो देयर विल बी डब्ल्यू इनपुट. ओके, सो इट इज going to supply some energy to the room, house, this is your house. Okay, this is your surrounding. Okay, fine. Now what is given, let us understand. So heat pump is used to maintain the home at 24 degrees Celsius. Okay, now the house is losing the heat, how much, 1800 kilojoule per minute. Okay, and the heat pump is driven by electric motor. How much heat, how much work input? 12 kilowatt. Okay. Amount of heat absorbed from the surrounding. Kitna surrounding se absorb kar raha hai, Q2. So you have to find out Q2. And COP you have to find out. COP you have to find out. Okay, kaise solve karenge? Sketch to humne already bana diya. Okay. अभी हाउस 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट, व्हेन इट कैन रिजेक्ट, एटलीस्ट उतना तो जाना चाहिए रूम में, तो ही उतना अमाउंट वो रिजेक्ट कर पाएगा, यस और नो. ओके, सो Q1 इज 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट. ओके, देखिए हाउस कब रिजेक्ट कर सकता है इतनी अमाउंट, जब एटलीस्ट उतना तो इनपुट जाना चाहिए, तो ही इसके पास एनर्जी तो चाहिए रूम के पास. तो अगर हीट पंप 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट सप्लाई कर रहा है हाउस को या फिर रूम में, तो ये रूम उतना रिजेक्ट कर सकता है. ओके, राइट, सो वी नो व्हाट इज डब्ल्यू, डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू Q1 माइनस Q, यस. सो Q2 आपको फाइंड आउट करना है, सो Q2 क्या आएगा, Q1 माइनस W. Q1 कितना है, 1800. ओके, 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट, फर्स्ट हम क्या करते हैं इसको कन्वर्ट कर लेते. ओके, सी हियर हाउ टू कन्वर्ट, क्या दिया हुआ है, Q1 1800 किलो जूल पर मिनट, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू 1800 डिवाइडेड बाय 60 किलो जूल पर सेकेंड, सो कितना आएगा ये, 30 किलोवाट. इज इट क्लियर, सो क्या आएगा, Q1 कितना है, Q1 30 किलोवाट माइनस W कितना है, 12 किलोवाट, सो Q2 विल बी 18 किलोवाट, अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एब्सॉर्ब फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग 18 किलोवाट. नाउ COP, हाउ टू डिफाइन COP, COP ऑफ एन हीट पंप कैसे डिफाइन करते हैं, Q1 डिवाइडेड बाय W, कितना है Q1, 30, कितना है W, 12, सो 30 डिवाइडेड बाय 12 कितना आएगा, 2.5. सो व्हाट आर योर आंसर्स, अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एब्सॉर्ब फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग 18 किलोवाट एंड सीओपी इट इज 2.5. सो आई होप द एग्जांपल्स ऑन हीट पंप आर क्लियर टू यू. So you can expect such type of small example. These are really small examples. Okay, आपको सिर्फ ब्लॉक डायग्राम निकालना है और एक तो डिवीजन लेना है फिर सब्ट्रैक्शन करना है. सो डेफिनेटली एमसीक्यू में भी ऐसे क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं. राइट, सो माय मोटो बिहाइंड प्रिपेयरिंग दिस वीडियोस ऑन हीट इंजन, रेफ्रिजरेटर एंड नाउ हीट पंप इज टू गिव द क्लियर आइडिया. What are the functions? What are the heat inputs? How to calculate efficiency? How to calculate the COP? How to define efficiency? How to define coefficient of performance? So hope with these three videos, these are very basic and this is going to form the basis for second law of thermodynamics. The statements you can easily remember if you have understood all the concepts of heat engine, refrigerator and heat pump. The statements, most of the students, they find the statements little bit confusing, Clausius statement and Kelvin-Planck statement, which I will be going through from in my next video. We will going to learn about second law of thermodynamics and as well as the perpetual motion of second kind. Statement, I think now it is going to be very easy if you have understood the block diagram sketches of all the three concepts, that is heat engine, refrigerator and heat pump. So I have tried my best to explain the numericals step wise. So hope you are finding these videos useful. Please do like my YouTube channel and subscribe it and also hit the notification bell. You can also join us on the Telegram and you can find us on Facebook page. If you want the handwritten notes of the same subject, the link is given in the description box. And please don't forget to share with your friends so that they will also get benefited with it. So hope you are enjoying the learning with tutoringcluster.com. Thank you.